Hello everyone! In this video I show you how to assemble a Tamron 17-50mm f2.8 VC lens. Recently I had this lens which had problems with zooming. The problem was caused by a bent lens tube inside the lens. So I had to disassemble the lens, repair the lens tube and then assemble the lens. In this video I show you how to assemble the lens. If you're interested in the disassembly video, then the link is in the description below. Before I start, let me talk about the tools that I've used to assemble the lens. I've used a PH30 screwdriver and a metal tweezers. If you're interested in buying them, then the links are in the description below. I hope this video will be useful, helpful, informative and adds value to you. If that's the case, please like this video, subscribe to my channel or send me a donation. The links are in the description below. If you have anything to add to this video, then share it in the comment section below. Also, there's an update section in the description. If I have anything to add to this video after it has been posted, then I add it there. So I would highly recommend to check it. So, let's get started. Let's start the assembly by joining the two lens tubes. Those two parts of the lens tubes should match. The next step is to put back the lens unit. The flex cable should be next to that cutout. Align the hole of the screw, then put back the screws and their collars. Put back the next lens tube. Notice that the lever should be on the other side of the flex cable. The next step is to put back the front lens element. I align a mark on the front lens element with the lens tube, that way I can put back the front lens at the same position as it was there originally. Put back the collars and the screws. Tighten the screws. clean the front lens element if it got dirty. Put back the rear lens element. The secondary aperture lever should go through this hole. Put back the screws into the rear lens element. Put back the secondary aperture lever. The pin of the secondary lever should go into the cutout of the inner lever. Put back the screws. This is how the lens looks so far. Put back the next lens tube. Those two parts should be next to each other. The screw on the side of the lens unit should slide into that groove on this inner side of the lens tube. Again, those two cutouts should match. The cutout on the lens tube and the focus lever should be next to each other. Slide on the lens tube. Move the inner lens tube to the position you see on this video. This will hold the sliders in its place, so they will not fall into the lens. Place the sliders on the place where you can see that in this video. Slide the outer lens tube on the sliders. Put back the screws. Put back the screws. Align the lens tubes to see the place of the screw. Put back the screw. The screw should go through three layers of lens barrels. Continue with the other two screws. The next step is to put back the front lens tube. Put back the front lens tube in a way that the white line on it should be aligned with the part of the lens, as you can see on this photo. The screw on the side of the lens should slide into the groove on the inner side of the front lens tube. So this is how the lens should look like. Zoom a little bit out until the place of the remaining screws in the front lens barrel aligns with the silver corrode inner lens tube. That way it holds the sliders in their place and they will not fall into the lens. Put back the sliders. Slide on the front lens tube. Put back the screws. The next step is to put back the focusing lens barrel. Move the focus lever to this position. Those two parts of the lens should match. Slide the focusing lens barrel onto the lens. Move the lever of the focusing lens element to the place what you can see in this video. Put back the lever and the screw. Put back the screws into the rear of the lens. Put back the focus brush. Put back the zoom tube. The hole on the zoom tube and the place of the screw should be at the same place. Put back the zoom tube. There is one place where the tube can fall down to its place, so rotate it back and forth to find that. Align the hole on the zoom tube and the place of the screw. Put back the screw. Put back the screw in the flat cable holder. Put back the zoom brush. Put back the gyroscope. Put back the focusing unit. The gear of the focusing unit should go into that hole. If the gear doesn't fall into its place, move the manual focus ring a little bit. Put back the screws. Clean the cables if it is necessary. Put back the PCB, but first connect the flat cable, which connector is on the bottom side of the PCB. Put back the screws into the PCB. Reconnect the flex cables. Remove the switch panel from the rear lens sleeve. The VC sign on the rear lens sleeve should be aligned with the 70mm sign on the lens. Put back the screws. Put back the switch panel. The focus switch should be at the autofocus mode and the image stabilization switch should match the switch inside. Test the switches. When the focus switch is in autofocus mode, the manual focus ring should be stuck, and if it's in manual focus mode, then the manual focus ring should move freely. I would recommend to clean the rear lens element now, before the rear cover is installed. The cutout of the metal ring should be at that place of the rear of the lens. Put back the metal bayonet. The holes in the side of the bayonet should be at the electronic connector. Put back the four bigger screws into the metal bayonet. Tighten the screws. Put back the two smaller screws into the electronic connector. Put back the rear cover ring. We are done with assembling the lens. I hope this video was useful, helpful, informative and added value to you. If that's the case, please like this video, subscribe to my channel or send me a donation. The links are in the description below. If you have anything to add to this video, then share it in the comment section below. So, thank you very much for watching my video and see you next time in my other videos.